I don't know if it's going to happen this week, Michelle, but it certainly, I think everything seems to suggest that we're inching close to a deal, particularly on what has been one of the so-called poison pills, the rules of origin for the automotive sector, which has been one of the most contentious issues. I think that Mexico and the U.S. are both flexibilizing positions. I think they're squaring the circle. I think they're very close to reaching a deal. So if they can get that piece off the table and announce that they've finalized that chapter, then I think some of the others that are almost done can be wrapped up. And then you're still going to have a couple of those remaining poison pills, particularly the so-called sunset clause, which would force the governments to review and renegotiate every 5 years, which is a no-go for both Canada and Mexico. And then the issue of ag seasonality of ag exports and the issue of government procurement. But if this can be wrapped up, maybe this week, maybe early next week by the technical teams, I think we're in good shape.
Antonio, what are you hearing? And this would all be done without Canada, right? That's pretty remarkable.
Yes, I agree with Ambassador Sarukhan. There are some pending issues. I would add the general dispute settlement mechanism that the U.S. wants to water down, and Mexico and Canada want to have it be much stronger, to have enforceable panels. And of course, as you mentioned, there's the issue of Canada. I think that Canada has a position on auto rules of origin closer to the U.S. than Mexico does. So if Mexico and the U.S. can reach an agreement, I think they can bring Canada on board. But for the sunset and dispute settlement, you need Canada at the table.
So, Ambassador, let's drive down on that point. Is NAFTA NAFTA if Canada isn't a part of it, or do you think Canada is going to come along one way or another, no matter what?
Well, it's clear that this has to be a trilateral deal. I think the current Mexican government and the incoming Mexican government have to unequivocally state that the negotiation has to be trilateral, that NAFTA has to be a trilateral deal. I think the fact that Canada isn't here present today in this particular negotiation over the rules of origin, we shouldn't read too much into it. As Antonio has said, U.S. and Canadian positions on that specific issue are much closer than Mexican U.S. positions. I think it would be relatively easy, if there's an agreement between Mexico and the U.S. on this specific chapter of rules of origin, that then Canada can be brought in to harmonize and then ensure that the three parties are on the same page.
Antonio,
it's another story, though, on the issue of sunset and dispute resolution.
Right. Understood. Antonio, if this deal goes the way it seems to be going, with some compromise on rules of origin in the 70% neighborhood or something like that, who wins and who loses here? Are both sides going to be able to say that, or all three sides, I should say, are all three sides going to be able to say it's a better deal for everybody?
Yes, so the regional content requirements right now are 62.5% regional value added. And if that content is raised, you know, the three countries could say there will be more regional inputs. But it will be very important to hear the views from the auto producers. If the auto producers can say, hey, we can live with those new rules and we'll actually keep investing in the region, that's fine. If they're not happy with those rules, then we have a big problem.